An Academy. Let's crack it.
Hi everyone, I'm Karthik Garg. I had secured All India Rank 16 in CLAT and All India Rank 5 in MHCET back in 2019. I am from Barnala in Punjab and I am currently pursuing my third year of the 5-year BLLB program at National Law School of India University, Bangalore. Now, in this short video, I'll be taking you through my journey as a CLAT aspirant as well as my journey as a law student. Before starting with my preparation strategy, I would like to talk about the motivation behind my preparation, and like every other law student, I also wanted to be in one of the topmost law colleges of the country at first, and this aspiration is what drives me towards this goal. I always wanted to enter NLS, and when I entered, I realized that it was not as easy going as I expected it to be, but the life here is totally worth experiencing, and despite some ups and downs, I assure you you'll enjoy the college life to the best, and you'll get a lot of exposure, and it'll really be a very good experience, and that is a good enough motivation for you to start taking your law entrance exam preparation seriously. Now, when I started preparing for CLAT back in April 2018, I prepared for around 14 months and I appeared for my exam in May 2019. I was very underconfident at the beginning, and the very thought of competing at the national stage was scary, but I thought that I should give it a shot, and luckily it worked for me. Now, when one starts preparing, one always wonders how it would feel like, you know, succeeding in the exam, but I want to tell you that at first it feels really good when the results are declared, but after that, after a few days, after a few weeks, you realize that what you did is your past, and what you have to do is your future, and for that you have to work right from the scratch again. So that happiness is short-lived, and you have to work as hard as you did during your preparation while you are in college as well. So apart from MHCET and CAT, I would say like ALIT, SLAT and LSAT are really important exams that you cannot ignore. ALIT is generally a tough exam, and being tough is not a reason for you to leave it, because the level of difficulty always translates into cutoff being on the lower side. So if you can manage to attempt questions with accuracy in ALIT and get less of the negative marks, then you'll be able to do pretty well. And as you know, NLUD is ranked the top right up with NALSAR and NLS. Also, Symbiosis and Jindal are also pretty good private universities, and the preparation for their exam is quite similar to the other exams except for the interview component. Now, coming to the preparation, I began by covering my basics first, and I also had to develop a habit of reading newspaper daily. I did not give many tests during that time because I knew I hadn't prepared enough, but after 3-4 months, when I knew that my basics were covered, and when I knew that I had read a lot of stuff and I knew what I had to read going ahead, when I was not as clueless as I was before, then I started giving my mocks, and at first the mocks could remain pretty steady, and though I tried different strategies, but I found one which I was most comfortable with. Then using that strategy, I tried to focus on my section wise performance as well, and instead of say trying to score 12-15 marks 12-15 marks out of the whole exam, I tried to score 3-4 marks per section, which is basically the same thing, but when you focus section wise, you have more chances of succeeding than trying to take the whole picture at once. Now, this brings me to the weaknesses and strengths which everyone talks about. To be honest, I was good at maths, quantitative aptitude and reasoning, so I really liked solving them, and but you also have to keep in mind that there is limited time you have to devote to each section during the exam, so I could not spend 20-25 minutes on the quantitative section alone, so I had to limit my time. Generally the rule is that don't devote more than 10% of the total time of the exam to math section, because it will just eat up your time and you may not even be able to solve the question. So I fixed 10 minutes for math section, and then I moved on to attempting reasoning and GK. After that, since GK takes a lot less time and helps you score a lot more marks after GK. You have a lot of time left for legal and English. I tried to finish legal section first. Legal section was pretty, I did not find it easy nor very difficult, but if I had enough time I scored pretty well in legal as well. And at last I left English for last because I always felt that English section was a bit precarious for me, because I was never 100% confident about any answer I had to mark. So if there is one section for you that you are really not sure about, you should leave it for the end and just devote it as much time as it is left in the exam, and not waste much time on that section because that won't help you score well. Now coming to MHCET in particular, which is just in a few days, I would say that as you all know, it is an online exam and there is no negative marking, so you have to attempt 150 questions. And I would also say that as far as it is possible for you, just try to read all the questions so that you don't just blind guess every question, and start with the sections you are good at, and then when you are over with them quickly, so you can devote more time to your weak spots, which will help you score marks in your weaker sections as well. Just a tiny point that if you are confused between two options during the exam and there seems to be a deadlock and you cannot find cannot decide which option to choose from, just leave that question and move ahead, because there is no point wasting time there. And your vision must be pretty clear during the exam, like what question you should attempt, what question you should spend your time on, and what question you should mark randomly. You must have that clarity in your mind, and then if you have that clarity, you'll surely be able to score pretty well. Now since the exam is in just a few days, I would also like recommend everyone to attempt as many mocks as possible, because they are the ultimate preparation strategies for you, because they'll help you know the stress level and how will help you how to handle it. You could attempt other mocks as well, not necessarily MHCET, but just keep the structure of MHCET in mind. The exam of MHCET is not very tough generally, but I don't know what paper setters have planned this year, so there could be surprises. So trust yourself, trust your preparation, and if you're prepared sincerely enough, you'll be able to tackle any of it. So lastly, on how to manage stress before and during the exam, I would say that it is important you have clarity in your mind. Just do not think about anything else, be in the present. Maybe if you want to exercise, meditate, jog, listen to music or whatever you feel like, and do not panic. Some cliche points like reach the exam center before time so that you don't have to hurry and carry all the documents, so that you do not unnecessarily add up to the stress level. And I would also recommend not studying on the morning of the exam, just because it will mess up with your mind, honestly, and your preparation, whatever you prepared till the previous day is as good as your preparation on the day of the exam itself. So there's no point stressing your mind on that day. And during the exam, I don't think you should face any difficulty if you have given enough mocks. And in fact, my experience of MHCET was it was the first exam that I had given at the national stage, and I did not feel it because of the mocks I had given. So if you have given enough mocks, you will not feel any difference, and you'll be able to manage it pretty well, I'm sure. Yeah, just maintain that mindset you have during the mocks and you'll be good to go. So best of luck, and I hope this video helped you.